a memorable party that we were invited to, which I'll always remember this, was before we got our record deal. We were running around doing a lot of club dates and things like that. And at the time, Tina Ferris, who is the Roots tour manager, and she's the tour manager for Chris Rock, at the time, she was working with the Roots, and she said, hey, I want you guys to perform at this party. And we're like, okay. And so it turns out that the party was Stevie Wonder's grandson's birthday party. Mm-hmm. And his grandson was only like 2. And so we're like, you got us singing at a little kid's birthday party. She's like, yo, it's Stevie. So, but we were down. Because like anything that was going to get us into Stevie's house, mm-hmm. it was like, we'll do whatever. Like, we'll sweep the floor. So we walked in there and we're like, we brought the whole band. It's like,
and we 11. Brought Jasmine Sullivan with us.
And
too.
We brought Jasmine Sullivan 15, with us. She's a kid at the time. And so we all get in this van and we're rolling up on this on the property. And it's in Jersey. And so we're driving up and it's got this big gate on the front. It just says Morris on the gate, and we're like, oh. And so the thing like opens up. It's like you go into Shangri-La. It's like, ah. And then we walk in and we go into the house and we set up, and it's like a ton of us, right? So we're like, these people probably thought they hired like a cover band and they don't know what they're about to get. So we get in there, we set up. I know they're all looking at us. We have the horns and everything, and then it's like time for us to perform, and Stevie's there and his grandson is there and his daughter's there. Everybody's chilling, and then we just go, ba-da-da. Because we used to start the show with these hip-hop, like,
he was doing
samples.
HNIC by,
yeah, like, we would start
Prodigy
our shows,
back then.
Like, we would come out like that. So people would think we're coming out to this R&B, like, soft, da, da, da. But we would start our shows like that. So we were just like, everything starts, and we're like, ba-da-da, ba-da-da-da, ba-da. And so we like rocked out in the living room at Stevie's house, and it's like we wore everybody out. And they're like, afterwards they're just like, oh, happy birthday. So it was great. It was like the best experience of my life. Afterward, we got a chance to sing at the piano with Stevie, and he was awesome. It was
I got one more house party I ever been to. One more thing, crazy story in our journey, for the most part. When we first started and got signed to what was Hidden Beach Records, Michael Jordan was actually one of the investors in Hidden Beach Records. So, you know, he's, I guess, in some ways kind of responsible, or, you know, helped us along in the journey, because some of his monies was filtered into those projects in some way. And he had this golf classic that he used to do. He may still do it. And at the time, it was down in Bahamas. So we all went down to Bahamas, and we were going to get our opportunity to finally meet Michael Jordan. Of course, everybody knows, you know, you're really, really looking forward to meeting Michael Jordan. So we were really, really excited. We go into this party, and, you know, I think Steve McKeever, who was the president of the record label at the time, is about to introduce us to Michael Jordan. So we all really anticipate and really looking forward to what's Michael going to say, what's our report going to be.
We're waiting for the word from Michael Jordan.
The word from Mike. And so we get there, and we like, hi, I'm Fatine, I'm Major, da-da-da, and Michael introduces himself. And the first thing out of Michael's mouth is, let's do this fucking shit. And it was like,
okay. Sure.
So, you know, we always remember that. We always think back to basically like Mike set it off with letting us know that we were about to do this fucking shit.
Yeah. So. That's like an inside joke with us now. Yeah, every time we go do something, we're like, let's go do this fucking shit.
It was like locker room banter. You know what I mean? In a sense, the same thing he might say to some guys before they go to the game.
Yeah.
But it was just like, it was Michael Jordan. And it just was like this
Michael
illustrious
Jordan's
moment.
Like your third grade teacher. Like, you don't think he's going to come to, you think he's going to get you like, look, this is what we're going to do. It's going to be fantastic. You know, he's going to give you like this pep talk. And then he just like cussed. And we were just like, I mean, I know we know everybody cusses, but it just was just, I don't know, it was just weird to us.
It was weird to us.
We were like, okay, sure. Let's do it.
Man, we've been very, very lucky, to be honest, man, because maybe it's simply because we're a husband and wife duo, like some things that we kind of really stay away from, to be honest, though. We don't really get into a lot of the crazy, crazy parties that, you know, people be having and different things that we've heard that be going on. So I can't really think of anything that's really like...
We don't really get invited to the crazy
yeah,
parties.
Yeah, they don't want us there, man, for some reason. Like,
We always have to get home. Like, we always have like, oh, the babysitter's there.
We can't afford to get into a situation that's going to be too wild.
Yeah, I mean, like, most of the people that we've been around been really the chillest and the best that they've ever been. Truth be told, a lot of times we get stories told to us about how wild people are.
And we can't believe it.
And we're like, what? Like, that person's always so chill, and their environment is always so chill.